Welcome to the Pilgrims Project.
Hey people, this is the Pilgrim, and we're back on the Valguero castle build. I had a bunch of replies about what to build next for the town, and OlympicWarrior suggested a survival shop. I had a bit of a chat about it, like putting weapons on display and things like that, so I sort of built up this place with that in mind. It's got a workshop on the bottom floor for crafting armour, weapons, ammo, that sort of stuff. There's a small repair shop under the balcony outside here. The main floor is the shop. The whole build has sort of a roleplay RPG theme, but you guys can put these designs to whatever use you want really. I built this like a basement for the shop. Like I said, you have everything under here for crafting. I could do with trying to fit a couple of indie forges into the build somewhere. I think when I come to build the fort, I'll have like a dino gate for the main entrance and I can put them just inside there so you can bring your dinos in, drop the metal off. So yeah, I think I covered everything down here. You've got the chem bench there and you know, because you're going to need to make tons of gunpowder and stuff like that. And yeah, there's loads of room for vaults and smithies and stuff. I built the shop section up above out of wood, and this is supposed to be like the basement, and that's all built with stone. Gives it a look like it's been built on like a foundation, and I think it keeps in line with the medieval theme for it all. And I've managed to line this build up pretty well with the gravel road as well, so that looks good. This is the main entrance to the shop. I didn't want just like a 6x6 square building, so I built this on the side just to sort of cater for the stairs and the balcony above. But yeah, it's starting to look like a proper little town now. Might need more room. And this is the survival shop. I've got taxidermy stands displaying armour and weapons on the left there, and the auto guns in this corner. I took a few ideas from the round gun shop that I built. And this is the weapons display that I talked about with Olympic. I was looking for a way to have the weapons hanging off the wall, but with official settings, so like no clip was active or anything like that. And you can just make out the hands holding the guns, but if you stick leather gloves on them, you can't notice it at all. Some of the buttstocks are sticking through the wall maps, but it's as close as I'll get them without like arms and legs off the models in the back sticking through. And they are just like wall maps painted black. I painted one by hand and then saved it and just copied the rest. I think getting a mod like RP visual storage, you know, on the official game, that'd be great, that make things like this. But we'll have to wait and see. Maybe a few of the mod contest winners might make it onto official games in some form. And over here I just made like a small sales desk in the corner. The shop, it's not a massive thing, but the display takes up a lot of room behind here. Back here I just put some smithies and some more storage. This lead down here leads back into the workshop underneath. And this is where the stands for the displays are hidden. Yeah, it does look a bit creepy. I probably should have dressed them in something, to be honest. But you can see how it works now, though. I just posed them in the flying position. So you've got the hands clipping through the wall maps to hide it all. And placed torches to the, you know, just to sort of hide the hands a little bit. But like I said, put some gloves on them and you can't tell. But I think it worked out pretty well, that. Okay, next it's the small tower in the centre and the roof spaces. Each of the triangle roofs has enough room for like bunk beds and storage. And just over here is like a small balcony. That's just over the shop entrance. It just added a few more angles and made the build look a bit more interesting. And that's the tavern over there from the last video. If you're seeing this build for the first time, this build videos for the whole castle walls and the gatehouse you can see over there. And for the tavern and the blacksmiths in that left-hand corner as well. But I'm going to build the dog kennels next, and then a small fort next to the cliff. And I think I'll build up to the plateau above with some cliff platforms and lifts. And the rest of these rooms are just similar with bunks, storage. And the centre bit for the tower. That just needed something a bit extra for the roofs to go into instead of it being like just all the triangles meeting. Look good. Don't know what to use this top room for. You suppose your archers could come up here if you're ever under attack. It's got a good view of the whole building. Yeah, Valguero looks great. I really want to climb one of those mountains over there. I put Ghost on and had a look around out there, but you get killed after a while. I know, like the red zone in Extinction. But I think with God mode on, it might be okay. And a lot of the ground out there, including the mountains, are all pretty much solid textures. Yeah, so there we have it. I think with clip active, you could probably make some like great stuff for in here, you know, for the shot bit. But I wanted to keep it so it was all good for official and console and everything. The rugs, you can get them engrams from Aberration for that. That's always a question that seems to pop up. Oh, and the Manticore shields you could see on the walls. That's just a trophy wall mount with the actual shield skin in it. Right, build tutorial next. I've got a structures list in the comments section if you want to check that out. I've covered the foundation layout and explained a few things along the way, so it's a bit more of a tutorial than a speed build, this one. Yeah, so have fun building, guys, and I'll catch you later. There's a couple of big chunks out here now that you can't actually build around where the supply drops are. So like one near the cave and one just outside the main gatehouse. It wasn't like that when I first started building over here, and it's basically stopping you building the exact same shape that I've done. You know, where the castle walls and everything are. But all I can think to do is maybe ask Nikitas. No, the guy that actually made Valguero, he's still working on it with Wildcard and everything. If there's any way you could change where the drops are, you know, just to move them over a bit so we can carry on building it. You know, it's a big ask, but you never know. But can't hurt just asking about it.